The New York Times announced earlier this month that they would revamp their homepage, saying the new design is easier to use across a wider variety of devices. But now that it's out, it's sparking controversy.
The new site, shown here, has fewer stories, and the Times says the new arrangement and cleaner look makes it easier for readers to find topics of interest to them. But something is missing. Some readers are crying foul that the Times has removed reporter bylines, arguing that they click on certain stories specifically because of the byline, and that it diminishes the work of the reporter.
I have to agree with that. I mean, this is, if content is king, then the people who produce it are the queens and kings. I mean, it's like, you know, you take away somebody's, any story by C.J. Chivers, any story by Maggie Haberman, I want to know what, I don't, you know, I do, I'll click on anything essentially, but if it's somebody that I really like, that's who I want to read.
I find it's ironic because a lot of these big papers have been building up their you know, frontline reporters as a big star.
Putting them on TV.
They put them on TV. They're well-known names. The reason they do that is because they know people will read and pay attention because they're, you know, their names. They see the faces. Now all of a sudden you're taking it away. I think you're taking some of that out of the equation.
We got to point out this is only on the homepage.
Right.
Apparently the Times is planning to beef up the identification with reporters elsewhere to, you know, show a picture, to provide biographical background information.
Won't get
so
that
moving
low.
In two different directions.
That's the homepage.
Yeah. Right.
I feel like the Times has gone a little too far in trying to make their reporters into stars. I mean, there's a little bit. I mean, a little bit of behind the scenes I can see being interesting, but I feel like the Times has put behind the scenes front and center. You know, there's the daily, and then there are other features. I mean, I feel like every time I go through the Times,
okay,
I'm stumbling on. Yeah, you know, in my personal experience, the only people who care about bylines are journalists and
their mothers. Yeah.
Exactly.
Well, I don't know. I think that one of the things that I always talk to people about in terms of credibility when you look to see what news sources are credible is where did it come from? Where was the source? How did you get there? And that's part of the credibility. So for me, after C.J. Chivers did that piece in Russia about those kids being killed, there's no more need be said.
That's the same story I always cite.
I'm telling you, whatever.
I remember exactly where I was when I was reading that.
Thank you. That is an amazing piece of journalist and writing and all of the stuff that you would want people. That, as far as I'm concerned, I see that byline. I'm going there to see what C.J. Chivers has to say. And that's not a name I'm pointing out in this conversation we're having, like a Maggie Haberman that people have become to know because of her appearances on cable. I like Maggie Haberman. Same reason I think that she has very good sources and what's the guy's name? Schmidt. Mm-hmm. You know, these people I'll go look to because I know they have sources. You may be right that other people don't pay attention, but I think that readers who are looking, particularly now in times where we question where does the information come from, who got it, I'm going to rely on the people that I know who have gotten it and gotten it more times than I can count.
I think people do pay attention. Yeah. Why? Because we're processing so much information. You're going from website to website. You don't have time to really dig through and read everything. So what you do is you go through and go, oh, that's that reporter. I'm going to read that. And I'm going to read. Maybe if you have time, you'll come back and read some of the other material. So you look for the names.
You
and
prioritize.
That's where you stop.
Why are they including the names or the bylines of opinion writers? That's sort of is
they're superstars.
I would also add that they want to make it clear. That's not what we said. Yeah. That's what these people said.
Plus, those are considered their superstars.
Yeah.